What up, Long Beach? Welcome back to GazetteSports.com. It's Tyler.
And JJ, and this More League Boys basketball video is brought to you by Naples Rib Company.
The party is on. Compton and Long Beach Millican together. Now you know you in trouble. Last time these two teams met, Compton scored 100. Last time Millican played, they scored 116. That is not a typo.
No lie, no lie. And when you put down 41, which Brian Chambers did two nights ago, they send you that kit. You already know the names and faces.
Malik Marchetti.
First-year head coach Chris Francis.
On the Compton side, Isaiah Bailey.
Fellow junior Isaiah Sweeney.
And head coach Tony Thomas. Let's just get this thing tipped off because it should be fun, and it was. Teams early running off of the opponent's misses. Bailey in transition with that easy lay-in, but obviously Rams running right back at you.
Running, running, keep running, running. Chambers with the stop, pop, drop. Ooh, that's all the way wet. And of course, Millican off steals. You know that's what they do. Mark Thomas, beautiful lay-in right there for the early lead.
But the Tar Babes coming back with the passes. Evion Harris with the dunk, and then Bailey is going to get a layup, breaking that pressure. Tony Thomas said he had a new press break for this game, and oh my goodness, look how quickly Millican comes right back off of a bucket.
If you've been watching these videos, you've seen these types of clips every time we cover these Millican Rams. A three is just as good as a layup, offensive rebounds aplenty, and then another layup on a loose ball. Chambers heating up in this one, hits the three, and then beats the buzzer at the end of the first quarter. Agent Zero, womp, 12 points in the opening 8 minutes.
And that would give Millican the 18-14 lead. Obviously, Chambers at times can carry his team for whole quarters at a time. Robert Lewis on the other end, three big buckets off the Tar Babe bench to start the second quarter. He had 10 points coming in, really made an influence.
Tar Babes had 22 points off the bench. Millican, though, with some offensive rebounds in the first half, something they haven't had a lot. Team Jacob for that three. And then how about Reggie Pope out there? Lundy Mallett finding him for that open shot.
And then off the takeaway, like you always see, sometimes those outlet passes get picked off. Chambers always waiting to throw down that triple. The Rams hanging tough, but when Compton did break through that pressure, it led to some easy buckets.
Well, easy is relative. That was a pretty hard take right there from Bailey, but Deshaun Hill, that's a nice big man move from the young boy. And then Bailey again. Excuse me, I'm gonna step around you right quick. 6-0 run for Compton. They take a 5-point lead to the break.
And you just felt like it was gonna be exciting and continue to go back and forth. It did in the third quarter. Thomas Pua knocking down the three. And then Hill with the layup, but right back at you, posted in the corner. Pua, again, 7 of his 9 points came in that third quarter, and they were big.
Offensive rebounds, Millican in the first half, more Compton in the second half. Zeno Lake and the foul, and then Lewis on the leak out. Babes were able to keep the lead for the majority of the second half.
But Millican did take it back. Ryan Easley, number 4, with the 4-point play. All of his points right here put Millican out in front in that third quarter. Though the Babes would answer back as Marquise Scott lays this one up and in. Compton takes a 2-point lead into the final frame.
Again, back to those offensive boards. This time it's Bailey. The Rams won't let them go away, though.
They are not going anywhere. Chambers running the distance, laying that in, and look at the ball movement. Marchetti down to Chambers for the lay-in. It's a 2-point game, 3:16 left to play in the fourth, setting up for a great finish, and then Marchetti, tough move.
That's how you go around the high ball screen right there. Tar Babes were aggressive on the other end, and then got to the line. Massive, massive free throws from Harris and Bailey to get a 3-point lead.
Yeah, Marchetti had just tied it, put him up by 3 there, and then he drops the dime to Pope, making it a 1-point Compton lead with 90 seconds left.
They burn the clock a little bit. Cartwright to the 10. That's not going to go in, but Sweeney with the putback.
Huge tip right there, offensive boards. The story all night for Compton, 3-point lead. Millican timeout, 18 seconds left. Got to have a 3 here. Pope puts it up. No good. Gets his own rebound over to Chambers just before the horn. Ooh, that looked good.
So close to free basketball.
You see the fans in the background thought that one might have been going in. Bailey, 7 of 14 for 15 points. Sweeney was 5 of 12 for 13. On the other end, Chambers with a game-high 21. You knew it was going to be a good game. Did not disappoint. Props to these two teams for playing a great one.
This video brought to you in part by McCarty's Jewelry, here for you since 1932. It's just another great one. We keep showing up to these gyms on Friday night, on Wednesday night, and they just keep getting better. And we've got more to come.
Compton takes on Poly next week on Monday. Obviously, everyone's been circling that one. Tar Babes trying to go for the Moore League Championship. You want coverage of that and everything else, Long Beach Sports. There's no other place to go but GazetteSports.com.